Hello, welcome to my another session. In this session, I am talking about the structure of spinal cord. As you all know that spinal cord, this is the one of the part of central nervous system. This is the brain and this is the spinal cord. Such a spinal cord, this is the elongated in structure, cylindrical in structure and extends from the medulla oblongata. So the spinal cord arises from medulla oblongata and descending downward. In case of adult, the length of spinal cord, which is 42 to 45 cm, and the diameter of spinal cord, which is 1 to 2 cm in diameter. So the spinal cord, this is the elongated structure and which extends from the medulla oblongata. The respective region of the vertebral column, the spinal cord also divided into different region. So here the first region, which is known as the cervical region, then thoracic region, then lumbar region, then sacral region, and last region is the coccygeal region. So the spinal cord, which is divided into different parts in respect to the different part of the vertebral column. These are the cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral and the coccygeal region. This spinal cord, in case of 4 to 5 years old, in case of 4 to 5 years old individual, the spinal cord, which extends up to the last sacral vertebrae. So the spinal cord in the age of 4 to 5 years old individual, which extends up to the last part of the vertebrae, actually up to the last sacral vertebrae. After this stage, the growth of spinal cord stops, but the growth of vertebral canal continuing. As a result, in case of adult, the spinal cord extends up to first lumbar vertebrae, not at the last sacral vertebrae, as we told earlier. That's why the length of spinal cord becomes more shorter than the length of the vertebral canal. So here, this is the spinal cord, which extends from the medulla, this is the medulla oblongata, and it extends up to the first lumbar vertebrae. This brain, suppose that the brain which present inside the cranium or inside the skull. This is the rough diagram. So suppose that this is the skull or the cranium. At the lower region, there is the opening, and such opening is known as the foramen of magnum. Suppose that this is the opening, and such opening is known as the foramen of magnum. So the spinal cord, it comes out from the skull through an opening at the lower side, which is known as the foramen of magnum. This spinal cord, it runs inside the vertebral canal, inside the spinal canal of backbone or the vertebral column. The vertebral canal or the spinal canal, it is composed of by the successive neural canal of vertebrae. Each vertebrae, it has the opening, which is known as the neural canal. So because of the neural canal, which forms the vertebral canal or the spinal canal, through which spinal cord runs inside the vertebral column or the backbone. At the end of the At the terminal portion, the terminal portion of the spinal cord, which is cone-shaped structure, this is the tapering structure. Such concept structure is known as the conus medullaris. This is known as the conus medullaris. Such conus medullaris present inside the neural cavity or the neural canal of first lumbar vertebrae. So from such conus medullaris, there is no nervous thread of the spinal cord. So from conus medullaris, there is the extension of the piameter. This is the filamentous structure. So from the conus medullaris, a thin non-nervous filamentous structure extends up to the coccygeal region. That's why through such non-nervous filamentous, it is believed that this is the extension of piameter, and this is the composed of the connective tissue which anchors the spinal cord with the coccygeal region. This non-nervous, this connective strand, this fibrous strand, this extension of piameter, which is known as phylum, F-I-L-E, phylum terminale. This is known as phylum terminale, which is about 20 cm in length. This is the non-nervous part. From spinal cord, the spinal nerve arises. In case of human, 31 pairs of spinal nerve arises. At the fifth lumbar region, the bunch of spinal nerve, is present, and such bunch of spinal nerve is known as cauda equina. So here there is three important terms. One is the conus medullaris. This is the terminal region of the spinal cord in adult, which present at the first lumbar region, which is cone-shaped structure known as the conus medullaris. This is the tapering structure. From such conus medullaris, there is the extension of fibrous connective tissue, non-nervous filamentous structures up to coccygeal region. This is known as the phylum terminale, which is about 20 cm in length. From spinal cord, spinal nerve, so this is the spinal nerve. In case of human, there is the 31 pairs of spinal nerve. So spinal nerve arises from the spinal cord at the lumbar, about fifth lumbar vertebrae, at the region of the fifth lumbar vertebrae, the bunch of spinal nerves present, and such bunch of spinal nerve, which is known as the cauda equina. Cauda equina means the tail of the horse. So there is the three important terms: conus medullaris, cauda equina, and the phylum terminale. So this is about the morphological structure of the spinal cord. Now come to the internal structure of the spinal cord. As you know, the brain, the outer region, this is the gray matter, and the inner region, this is the, there is the white matter. In cerebellum also, the outer region is gray matter and inner region, there is the white matter. But in case of spinal cord, the condition is opposite. It means the outer region, that is the white matter, and inner region, there is the gray matter. In the center of the spinal cord, there is the canal, and such canal is known as the central canal. This is known as central canal. This central canal, which is filled with the cerebrospinal fluid, and it communicates to the fourth ventricle of pons as well as the ventricles of brain. So this is the central canal, which is filled with the cerebrospinal fluid. Internally, it is lined by the ciliated epithelium, and such ciliated epithelium is known as the ependymal epithelium. So the central canal of the spinal cord, which is lined by the ciliated epithelium or the special type of epithelium, which is known as the ependymal epithelium. Here, the inner matrix, there is the gray matter. Suppose that this is the gray matter, and such gray matter which surround the central canal. So this is the, suppose that this is the gray matter. So here gray matter present at the inner region, and the white matter which present at the outer region. So this is the gray matter. Such gray matter which forms three pair of horns. This is the dorsal horn, this is the lateral horn, and this is the ventral horn. This is the dorsal region, and this is the ventral region. So this is the dorsal region, and this is the ventral region. The ventral region also, the ventral surface, it also, this is the anterior region, and this is the posterior region. So the dorsal, this is the posterior. Posterior region, and the ventral region, this is the anterior region. So at the dorsal region, there is the fissure. This is known as the dorsal fissure. This is the dorsal fissure, and there is the ventral fissure. Such fissures run along the length of the spinal cord. So this is the dorsal fissure, and this is the ventral fissure. And at the center, there is the canal, which is known as the central canal. And the gray matter, which forms the three pair of horns, the upper or the dorsal region, this is known as the dorsal horn. This is the dorsal horn, this is the lateral horn, and this is the ventral horn. Such dorsal horn, it contains the dorsal root of the spinal nerve, and the ventral horn, which contains the ventral root of the spinal nerve. And because of the presence of three pairs of horns, the matrix or the white matter. So outer, this is inner is the gray matter and outer is the white matter. So the white matter, which is divided into three regions, the dorsal region, which is known as the dorsal, or the posterior funiculus, this is known as the dorsal funiculus, or the dorsal column, or the posterior column of white matter, which is known as the dorsal funiculus. And the ventral side, there is the another column. This is the another column of the white matter at the ventral region. Such ventral column of white matter, which is also known as ventral funiculus. And at the lateral region, the white matter, which also form the another columns, and this is known as the lateral column of white matter. So this is the lateral horn of, sorry, the lateral column of white matter. This is the lateral column of white matter. So this lateral column of white matter is known as the lateral funiculus. And the plural form of funiculus, this is the funiculi. So because of the presence of three pairs of horn of the gray matter inside the spinal cord, the white matter of spinal cord divided into three number of funiculi, the three number of columns, the dorsal column, the lateral column, and the ventral column of white matter. So the dorsal column of white matter, which is known as the dorsal funiculum, the lateral column of white matter, which is known as the lateral funiculus, and the ventral column of white matter, which is known as the ventral funiculus. So this is the internal structure of the spinal cord. So the spinal cord, it also protected by the meninges as found in case of brain. So here there is the three number of meninges also, as well as such spinal cord, it is protected by the vertebral column because it present inside the vertebral canal or the spinal canal of the vertebral column. And it also protected by the bony, the ligament and the cartilage. So this is the whole about of the structure of the spinal cord. Thank you for watching.